Hello friends, welcome to LabTex. My name is Nasir and today we have received a co-to-do HP CQ40 model. However, it is a very old model and I don't know what is the status. Let's come and check live that what is the actual scenario in this board. Now come and see. So now you can see that this is the motherboard and very newly motherboard it seems. Nobody has worked on this and let's plug in DC jack and check what is the condition. Now you see, first thing you have to observe your DC power supply, and instead of power supply, if you use adapter, then what you will find out that adapter light would be blinking. So what does it mean? That the reverse current is going back to the adapter, and that is causing to blink the power supply. It could short the power supply as well. So you don't have to use any longer this types of process. So what you have to do, you have to find out that something has gone wrong. As I have told you in our shorting video, that you have to be very careful at the time while you are injecting the DC in voltage into the motherboard. The voltage should not fluctuate ever. And what should be the condition of the amperage? Then it must increase as per the voltage demand or the current demand. So when it gets on, sometime when you take out the RTC battery, then you will find out that automatically the board will turn on. So in that case, you will find out there would be the 1 ampere and 1.5 ampere you will find on the this CC point. That is the constant current. And now the second thing I would like to tell you here, the CC is something that which is telling you that the constant current, however the motherboard is require more current to this. So that is why this light is appear on this CC point. So it should not be on this point, because the maximum load of the motherboard, of any motherboard, cannot go 3.5 ampere. Even if you use the writer, hard drive, and you use the battery, so battery consumes more current to the CD writer and the hard drive. So the maximum current will reach up to 3.5 ampere as it is written on the adapter. So now in this way we can understand that there is the major shorting in this motherboard. So now let's come and find out that what point you have to check in this case. So usually what does happen if you get this types of case, so you will find out that the primary area of DC in will be having a short circuit. So in that case you have to take out, you have to eradicate the shorting first of all, then you apply the power once again. So what I am going to do, as I have recommended you, in the motherboard what you will find out, you will get two sensing resistor. As you have gone through DC in, or Dildar sir must have told you that this is the final area of 19 volt. So here you will see here that 12 milli ohm resistor is there. That is the sensing resistor, and this is the final area, this sensing resistor, where after the blocking and switching MOSFET, the voltage will finally reach on this point. Then you can expect to have the 19 volt across the motherboard, like a core area, like the 1.8 and 1.5 volt regulator, and 1.05 volt regulator for the PCS supply. So everywhere in the motherboard you will get 19 volt okay if you are having the good impedance on this resistor. So now let's check this resistor on the multimeter. So here you can see that by testing this point only, you can tell very easily that this area has gone short. Now let me put it on the beep so that you can hear the beep sound as well. Now see the situation, it is beep. As I have told you in our theoretical class, that what should be the actual value of 19 volt. If you haven't seen that video, please go through that video once again. If you don't have that video, so you can contact us to get that video, because we have explained lots of things over there, ranging from the charging IC's internal logic, 3.3 and 5 volt internal logic, RAM IC internal logic, as well as the core IC internal logic, and the communication of PCH and IO. Many more things has been described over there with the very depth level. So the situation is here that you can confirm that 19 volt is short. Now what you have to check more, that any else area, like you can see 19 volt is the same place, but this is due to my experience. I am checking on this point. Also you can check it here. Now the same 4 ohm you are getting on this point. So in this way you can determine that your 19 volt is across motherboard is short. But what problem you confront at the time while checking the motherboard in the matter of shorting only, that you get confused to check that where you have to locate the 19 volt capacitor. So that sometime become the very, you know, tough task to you to find out that 19 volt, because there is no big types of resistor. Like in some motherboard, like this type of motherboard, you will see here that the big capacitor over here and the small capacitor here. Small indicates you that the less voltage would be on this place, and this is definitely the 19 volt. By just observing this capacitor, you can tell that there 19 volt will come. But in this motherboard, you find out that if the 5 volt capacitor is used for the same place as well as the 19 volt capacitor is on the same size. So in this way you will get confused that where you have to check. However, we have told you in our any regulator class that the high drive of the MOSFET you can also check. So let me show you to check this high drive of MOSFET. Like here is the two MOSFET. One would be the low drive. So low drive always will be zero. So it is low drive. Now the high drive, let me check. So it is a high drive drain side, and it is also giving me the same value as the 19 volt was giving. So there are the so many places where you can identify the 19 volt area, and the best area is the sensing resistor. So the condition will tell you all about the story. Okay, this is the cover page of any book, and it will tell you the story of each and every chapter of the book. So I hope that you came to know that how you can determine the 19 volt area in the. Now let me tell you how do you eradicate shorting from the motherboard. Let me tell you the basic process of removing shorting from any motherboard, not to talk about only the Core 2DU and the 10th generation. Even if you have any of the model, the same process you can apply in the motherboard, in the desktop motherboard, as well as in the mobile processing motherboard. This is the wire which will tell you that where exact point is short. So for that you need to have this power supply only. Okay, there must be at least 5 ampere in the power supply, or if you have above ampere, like 10 ampere also comes in the same power supply. So each and every power supply has the 30 volt maximum limit and 5 ampere, but in mobile power supply maximum 2.5 ampere comes, which is not efficient to work on the laptop motherboard. So now let's come and put a jumper wire on this area or this any of the terminal. Okay, as you can see that I have fixed this wire on the one terminal of this sensing resistor. And this resistor is you can consider that 19 volt is here. And what you have to do, you have to use alligator clip on the negative terminal of this power supply. And first of all, before powering up, you have to mind it that you have to reduce the voltage to the minimum level. Okay, as I have reduced it to the zero level. And if it is adjustable, if the current is not auto in your power supply, like you can see here, this is my power supply of 3 digit. So I need to adjust every time if I have, it is not auto. So manually I have to adjust current from, so from this notch I have to adjust again and again. So but what is the advantage of the 4-digit power supply? That it has the auto current. You can say that it is the auto regulator, and the current is regulated automatically. So you need not to adjust current, it is maximum level, and only you have to minimize the voltage. So now I am going to connect this alligator clip on the 19 volt sensing resistor terminal. Now what you have to do, you have to press it on, and gradually you have to increase the voltage, and now you can observe the current load is going up, and which indicates that somewhere is in the motherboard is faulty, and which is taking abnormal load, and the current is, or you can say that all the electrons of the motherboard is reaching to that point and looking for the holes, and it is acquired in the some place, and that would be getting rather heat, because you know that the current is, all the electrons is reaching in the single points, the consequently you will get the abnormal heat on that point. Now what you have to do, you have to find out through a temperature sensor or whatever you are having, even you can touch it by your hand. Now let me set it on the degree. So now the environment temperature, as you can see that it is 34 degrees Celsius in India. So now I am searching the place where the component is getting abnormal heat. So you can easily catch by, so I am trying to find out every point where the 19 volt is. So now 44 degree, and this area is having 60 degrees Celsius, as you can see on this temperature sensor. So this area is somewhere is faulty, even you can touch it by your hand. You have to be very careful at the time while you are touching it. You, let me tell you one thing here on the power supply. The best way, if you are not having the temperature sensor and if you are going to touch it by your hand, so it's better to increase the voltage at that level when you get the 1 point and 1.5 ampere on the current area. Like I would like to show you, like I have increased it to the 1 volt only, and we are getting 1.2. so never let it be exceed 1.5 volt. So adjust it this area. So in this way, what will happen that your hand or your whatever you are touching, the component which you are touching, so it will you will not get burnt by that component. This is the limit of touching any component if you exceed the voltage. Now if you touch it, I think you will get printed on your finger. Component print will come out in your finger, so avoid to burn your finger. So that's why I avoid to touch it by my finger. So instead I use this temperature sensor, that you can see that this area is getting abnormal heat. So in this area something is wrong. So exact point if you want to touch, like now let me put off my gloves, and what I will do, I will touch it by my finger only, because the best sensor the God has gifted you is your skin. The skin will tell you that where the actual point is. So here I can find out the last one. The last one is getting abnormal heat. So let me remove from this place. So let me show you once again. Let me show you the shorting point. So I have taken out this power supply. So the value of every 19 volt is the same. Here I am checking. Now you can see here, let me check this capacitor also. Now the same value you are getting here. Now let me remove the particular capacitor which seems that it is short, because my finger was burning when I was touching this area. So now there are the three capacitor remaining. If this is short, I will not use any other, because that is enough. If there would not be any of the capacitor, then I must use one PF on this place. Now let me check the same thing. Now you can see on the multimeter I am touching, on the beep sound I am touching here. Now you can see the shorting has gone, and let me test this capacitor. Now you can see the exact capacitor I have taken out. So maybe you can make mistake by checking the this thermal temperature, because it cannot tell you the exact one, but by checking your finger it tells you. But I rather prefer to avoid to touch by my finger, lest the finger is burnt. So I would like to suggest you, so take care while checking the major shorting in the motherboard. Now you can see even the same point while where I have connected this jumper. So this area was short with the 4 ohm. Now you can see that the shorting has been eradicated. So in this way I think my board is okay now. So let me do one thing. Let me power it up. So let me adjust it once again. This motherboard requires 18 to 19 volt. So let me put the DC jack into the motherboard, power on. So now you can see that the light is constant on the DC jack. Ampere is not taking too much high, nor my voltage is getting down. Shorting has finished from the board, and this light, what does it indicate to you? That my LDO is proper on my motherboard. If sometime you get this DC jack on and off, so it indicates you that there is something wrong with the air communication. So IO reset may be faulty, there might be fault with the LDO consistency. All the time the DC jack in or the motherboard is not getting proper LDO from the motherboard. So this thing happens. If you want to know about all these thing, that how this types of work and all these types of case study, then you can join our class. So let me power it up, and now you can see that it is on. And let me check the display in the motherboard. So let's see, does it come external with the BGA port? Also I will use my keyboard. Even I can use my, you can see on the CRO. Now I am using my CRO USB, and on the CRO if the display comes, it will be written then your device is connected with the computer. Now let me DC jack in, light comes, let me turn it on. You can see the successfully connected to your computer, so it indicates that the display has come. Now the finally you have to check on the LVDS area. So guys, as you have seen that how I have done this motherboard on live, because this types of problem, it is not necessarily will come only in the code review. Any types of motherboard if you receive, so you can confront this types of problem in your motherboard. So this is the particular case which I was giving you the experience, the outstanding experience you are getting from us. So if you have any confusion in the laptop repairing, if your concept is not very much clear, then you can have our class. So for your convenience, we have made the video of a bunch of our experience. There you will come to know that all about the regulator ICs, like a charging regulator, 3.3 and 5 volt buck regulator, and RAM regulator, core voltage regulator, all types of regulator and its functions and its requirements. All these things you will come to know. You will come to know how to reprogram the BIOS with the unique manner, with the excellence of editing, like the CSME region, TXE region, RSS signature. This all about we have combined it in the video course. If you want to know that PCH and IO particular communications, you can also contact us for the particular video of that particular section. Like if you don't know that how to check the LVDS area, then you can have that video also. So you can avail a video from us, like if you have confusion in the charging area, then you can have that kind of video. So it's not necessarily that you will get all the video along all together. So this is the advantage with you, and anytime from anywhere you can watch that video. So hopefully guys you have liked this video, and please hit the like button, and also if you haven't subscribed our channel as of now, so please subscribe it, and also hit the bell icon button so that we time to time upload the very unique type of video, very outstanding our experience on the YouTube channel. So you will be benefited for that. So guys, if you have any queries, you have any doubt, you can write on the comment box. And also if you have any queries for our classes, then you can contact on the given number. So thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video.